Hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior. Welcome back to X-Men Legends 2, Rise of Apocalypse. We are in the holding pens, about to go to the stockade, but we have one loose end to take care of, so let's take care of that right now. Now, this being a non-essential area, I wonder if there's any good stuff in here, besides riflemen. Yes, there is! You already see it right now, that's definitely a weapons cache. Now, if I can get by these guys, see what the other one is.
You should have run away.
And an atlas. Ooh, a comic book! Nice! That's exactly what I was hoping. It's kind of hard to tell the two apart, but I think comic book looks more like it is curved and shaped a little bit. But, it's not important. What is important is beating up Master Riflemen, because they are annoying. And Forsaken, because, well, there's a reason they're Forsaken.
That was fun!
Powers grow in strength.
And more stuff, nice! Danger Disc and another weapon cache.
Well, what have we here?
And some wise ass who wants to ambush me. And fail in the process. Because in order to ambush somebody, they must not know, you must not know they're coming. Or they must not know you're coming. That clearly didn't happen here.
Ha! Gotcha.
Anyway, I've been trying to record the last... This is my sixth attempt at it. At this part. You know, you just wake up, you have those days with Dazzle. I've been having... This is why I hated Dazzle, and this is why I love Dazzle. Because of the quality, but... Sometimes... Ugh. Man. You have days where you just can't get... 5 good minutes of footage. And I've been suffering through that this morning. I suffered through that yesterday as well. I'm trying it tonight right now and hoping that works. But... I apologize for that, but it's just a pain in the ass. It really is.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. You can use an Icor to teleport through this door. The door is unbreakable, but technically you're supposed to do is go around the other way to get to it. So you can open up the door. And you can't go past that force field. It's teleport proof.
I just had
a horrible time recording.
Getting up.
And what happened was, yeah, these days, it's just like, sometimes you get seamless footage, just seamless 2 hours of good, decent footage. And then you have times where you get, like, 5 minutes, and then you're like, okay, let's restart Pinnacle, or let's restart the computer, or let's unplug the Dazzle and replug. I did all those things. Nothing helped. So, I fought through it a little bit. I did a 25-minute part, and it came out like crap. Kind of like this whole point with this obligatory nonsense with enemies and cutscenes. But it's just been very difficult for me to actually get good footage. Because it kept desyncing horribly. You know, I say I always can tell when it's desynced right now?
Sweet dreams.
Because it sounds really bad in my headset. Well, I haven't had one where it sounded good and just didn't work. So I tried fighting through it, tried a couple more times, and they didn't work either. It's very rare that happens, but it's awful otherwise. Right here, we're facing psychic demons, and we already destroyed the booby traps you saw. That is a slow trap. That's all the traps you'll find in these prison areas is slow traps. And psychic demons also have the same effect. As you can see, Jean Grey is moving extremely slow. When you move slow, you attack extremely slow, you move extremely slow. And, well, it drags out the recording, and it also makes you go to hell, pretty much. Just goes to hell. It's like, let me move.
faster. I'm sick of this. My punches are taking 5 seconds each.
And you see, we picked up a sketchbook. Now, they have all these force fields so you can backtrack it freely. There's no point to it. Because once you get to the end, Blink will offer to teleport you back to the X-Mansion. So you don't have to take this long-ass path on the way back. And you could, instead of doing that, you can teleport yourself to, New York South Side instead of having to go through this and the sewers again. Which I'll show you later on. Not this part, obviously. But it's pointless that they do that, but they do it anyway. So now we get to these pipes. There are two ways you can do it. You can use telekinesis, Jean Grey, or you can push it with someone strong to get rid of this fire. If you do not have the part, well... Hold on. Enemies like to come out through that area. And it's one of those obligatory congested areas.
I'm pretty good, aren't
I? I'm sorry, I'd get sidetracked by that so easy. If there's too many things, I just have this obligation to use an attack and blow everything up in that area. Just to make a huge explosion or whatever.
Please, forgive me for that.
But if you did not go through, you cannot go through this area, then here's what you would have to do. You would have to walk around to the other side, break this fence right here, and jump over the railing to the other side. But the water is radiated. You'll take 10 damage for every second you stand in there. Not a big deal, but well, damage is damage if you don't look at it, or if you keep it unchecked. Ooh, inhuman cloak. And you'd have to deal with these Forsaken and move over to the next area.
Give me someone else to hit.
But on the plus side, you get to this weapon cache. To fill up if you need it. Wait.
You bet.
Sorry, obligatory knock everything down area. Tremor helps, can do it a little bit, but I really wish I had some fire's ignite, because ignite can damage like 10 objects at once, whereas Rogue doesn't have that much reach. You have to go through that door, by the way. If you go through the other door, you won't be able to jump over the center area, and the force field would stop you. So once you get through that area, just more lowering force fields. If you go to the right, you'll see the data disk right there. A couple of these guys. Not like they're worth it. And if you remember from the last part, I'm starting a new set of 4 now. Because I just got a +4 energy tank max. This congested area. This is the most congested area I've seen in a while. Even more congested, I think, than New York, with all these guys. And since there's enhanced damage, get rid of them as fast as possible. Which is exactly what I need to do there. And more inhuman stuff. Nice. Whatever. They go down very quickly for big guys. And this isn't an obligatory cutscene, but it shows you have to break a door down, so let's do that. It's just basically an endless flow, almost an endless flow. Feels like it, but isn't. With a slow trap there. But a large flow of bad guys. So once you get rid of a bunch of Forsaken and the Alice, the Psychic Demons come up with their attack that can slow you down.
and make you move extremely
slower than Slowpoke.
Please forgive me.
Hopefully they won't threaten me like the cloisters did that other time. Now, whatever. I don't even know where I was going, to tell you the truth, when I actually thought of that part. I think my mind was just in the gutter that day, and
sure
it came up. A part of me was thinking maybe I could use this and turn into a Pokemon LP, but I decided against it. Because, well, grad school and, like, 13 days, something like that. Kind of get in the way. Last I checked, that's more important. Like, I never LP during the school year ever. Which actually is true. Let's just keep down for these guys. I think we're about near the end of them. Yes, we are. So, next time around, we're going to go into the Brain Trust.